Hello everyone, today we will start the next part of the fifth unit, that is acceleration part. In this video we will study how to draw velocity and acceleration diagram, how to make acceleration table, how to divide the acceleration in the components like tangential and normal. The first of all, we will go through the first slide. Acceleration of a particle whose velocity changes both in magnitude and direction at any point. So acceleration have two components, that is normal acceleration and another one is tangential acceleration. So in normal acceleration, we know the formula of F is equal to mass into acceleration. Here the acceleration is the normal acceleration or centripetal acceleration or radial acceleration, which is given by mv square upon r, where m is the mass of the body in kg. So then what is the acceleration? The acceleration, that is normal acceleration, is v square upon r. The unit of normal acceleration is meter per second square. Tangential acceleration, this component of acceleration is perpendicular to link or parallel to the velocity of particle at the given instant. Whenever you draw velocity diagram, you will take the parallel line to the same link velocity, that is tangential acceleration. If you draw with the reference to the configuration diagram, then you need to draw a perpendicular component of the given link, that is tangential acceleration. By both methods you can draw. V is equal to r into omega. Here v is the linear velocity, r, that is the length of the link, and omega is the angular velocity. Whenever we differentiate the velocity with respect to time, we will get tangential acceleration. Here dv by dt is equal to r into d omega by dt. So we are representing tangential acceleration as a suffix t is equal to r into alpha. Here alpha is angular acceleration. So the total acceleration is the summation of the both, that is normal acceleration plus tangential acceleration. Now we will move to a numerical. First of all, we will see the first numerical. The question is, in a 4 bar mechanism ABCD, AD is fixed link and crank AB is rotating at 200 rpm in clockwise direction. The dimensions of various links are as follows. BC is equal to AD is equal to 150 mm. CD is equal to 80 mm. AB is equal to 40 mm. Find angular velocity of links BC and CD. So first of all, we have to draw a configuration diagram with the given dimensions. We will take the scale. Here the next part is, we need to find out the angular velocity of the crank. Here the RPM for the crank is 200. So omega AB is equal to 2 pi n by 60. Here RPM is given, that is 200 RPM we will put. So omega AB is equal to 2 pi into 200 divided by 60. So from here we will get angular velocity, that is 20.943 radian per second in clockwise direction. So next part, we need to draw configuration diagram. After that, we need to find out the velocity of the input link, so which we have drawn, and we have found out the velocity of link AB. Angular velocity but now we will find the linear velocity. V is equal to R into omega. So R is the length of the link, that is AB is equal to 40. So 40 into angular velocity is 20.943. So we will get linear velocity at B is 837.72 mm per second, or 0.8377 meter per second. So from that we will draw velocity diagram. So first of all, there are four links, that is AB, BC, CD and AD. As per the configuration diagram, link AD is fixed, so points A and D are the fixed points. So in the velocity diagram also, we will start with the fixed points. First of all, take points A and D in space. So these are the points we have taken. Draw vector AB perpendicular to the link which is in the configuration diagram. Now here, this is the link AB. We will draw a perpendicular line to link AB by a suitable scale. Here also, you need to take a proper scale and you have to mention it. So we will draw a perpendicular line AB. This one is the line perpendicular to the link AB. We denote this link as VB is equal to VBA. Now here we know the velocity of the link, 0.8377, which we have find out from the given data. Now select point B to go to the point C. Now from point B, we will draw another line which will be perpendicular to the line BC. Now here is the one of the other line BC, which is perpendicular to the link given in the configuration diagram. Okay, after that we will draw a perpendicular line from C to move to the D. So this line CD is perpendicular to the line or link which is in the configuration diagram. So this is the line CD which we have drawn perpendicular to the line CD. Now the intersection of the points, that is CD and BC, is point C. So now we will calculate the velocities of the various links. So the velocity of link CD, that is linear velocity. So first of all, we have to measure the length of CD. Now you have to multiply this length with the scale you have assumed previously. Now as per my scale, I got the linear velocity of link CD is 0.51 meter per second. So now I am going to find out the velocity of link BC, that is 4.5 into the scale 0.1, which is equal to 0.45 meter per second. So from that we have to find out the velocity of link CD. So angular velocity of link CD. So velocity, linear velocity, is equal to R into omega. So R is the length of the link CD into omega CD. So now we know the value omega CD as 6.375 radian per second in the clockwise direction. So we will put this value and we will get the velocity of link, angular velocity of link CD. Now from velocity of BC, you have to find out the linear velocity of BC. So velocity of BC is equal to length of the link, that that is BC into, that is 0.15 into angular velocity of link BC. So from here you will find out the angular velocity of link BC, that is 3 radian per second. Now we will start with the acceleration diagram. First of all, draw the configuration diagram, then draw velocity diagram. If you have drawn previously, then no need to draw it again. Now here, from here we will draw a table which have 4 columns. First is link, another one is the length of the link, third one velocity of the link, and fourth one is the acceleration of the link. So in our mechanism there are 3 links, AB, BC, CD, and the fourth link AD is fixed, so we haven't take it here. The lengths of the links are 0.04, 0.15, 0.08. We will find out the velocities of all 3 links from the velocity diagram, that is 0.837, 0.45, 0.51. Now we will find out normal acceleration for link AB. So we know the formula for normal acceleration is equal to V square upon R. Velocity is 0.837, that is square, divided by radius, that is the length of the link, it is 0.04. So from this ratio we will get normal acceleration as 17.514. For the link BC also we will follow the same method. For link CD also we will follow the same method. After that we will start to find out the tangential acceleration. The first link AB is rotating uniformly, so the tangential component is the derivative of the velocity with respect to time. Here the velocity is constant, so the tangential acceleration is 0. So for the link BC we won't find out the tangential component of the link because we don't know the angular acceleration. We know the direction of the acceleration component of link BC, which is perpendicular to the normal component of link BC. Same for the link CD, we don't know the value of alpha. Here we know the direction, and the direction is perpendicular to the normal component of link CD. Now we will draw acceleration diagram for the given mechanism. First of all, the crank AB is rotating at a uniform speed, so the tangential component is 0. So the total acceleration of the link AB is same as the normal component only, because here the tangential component is 0. As link AD is fixed, so we will start with the fixed points AD. We will take these points in space. First of all, we have taken points A and D in space. From that we will draw line AB parallel to the link AB, and we mention it as a normal component of acceleration of the link AB. We will select a suitable scale while drawing. We have to mention this scale before starting acceleration diagram. So here the normal component is the total component of acceleration for the link AB. Now to move point C we use point B. From point B draw a vector BC dash, which is in the direction of or in the parallel to link BC. We mention point C dash because this is not the final or total component of acceleration. This is the only one component, that is normal component of acceleration. So we mention this point, this line BC dash, as ACBN, that is normal component of acceleration of link BC. Now vector BC dash is our one of the component of the total acceleration. From C dash we will draw a perpendicular line to the link BC dash, that is the tangential component. So this one is the perpendicular component C dash C. C is not a fixed point. We have drawn in the direction. This is the infinite line C dash C. We don't know its value. We have drawn just the perpendicular component to BC dash, that is C dash C. This is with the infinite length. We don't know the point C. So next is, now from point D we will draw DC double dash, that is parallel component to the link CD, which is the normal component. So this is the one of the component of total acceleration of link CD. The one component we got, that is normal component. From this component we will draw a line perpendicular to normal component. This is tangential component of acceleration C dash C. So the lines C dash C and C double dash C will intersect at point C. Mark this point as C. Now join the lines, the actual resultant components of the acceleration or total components of the acceleration of link CD and BC. I have mentioned here the dark lines, dark black lines, as the total acceleration components. Now this is the acceleration diagram for the given mechanism. Now we will find the tangential components length. We have to measure C dash C and C dash C double dash C. Now the tangential component is R into alpha. So for the link CD we will measure the angular component of acceleration. This is asked in the question. So the linear component is 16.8. we have to measure the length CD, that is 16.8 is equal to length of the link 0.08 into alpha CD. From that we will get angular component of acceleration of link CD. Another component for CB, so here the acceleration component is 15.4, length of the link CB is 0.15 into angular component of link CB. So from here also we will get the angular component of acceleration 102.667 radian per second square. So we got the values of link CD and CB. Now there is one another numerical. An IC engine mechanism crank AB rotates at 600 rpm. The length of the crank AB is 0.5 and connecting rod is 2 meter long. The connecting rod here is BP. When the crank is turned 45 degree from IDC, that is inner dead center, find the velocity of piston P, angular velocity of connecting rod, that is BP, velocity of point D on the connecting rod which is at a distance 0.5 meter from B. So they have given the location of point D on connecting rod BP. It is at 0.5 meter from point B. First of all we will find out the angular acceleration of link AB. They have given the RPM value for the crank, that is 600 RPM. So omega AB is equal to 2 pi NAB divided by 60. We will put this value and we get the angular acceleration AB is equal to 62.831 radian per second. So now we will draw the configuration diagram as per the given dimensions. Here we will find out the linear velocity of link AB to draw velocity diagram. So linear velocity V is equal to R into omega. Velocity of link B is equal to length of the link BA into omega BA. length of the link they have given as 0.5 into omega value is 62.831. We will put these values and we will get 31.415 meter per second as a linear velocity of link BA. So from that we will start to draw linear velocity. First of all, locate point A in space because this is the fixed point. So first of all, we located the point A in space. From that point A, draw AB perpendicular line to the link AB. So we know the velocity of link AB is 31.415, which we have calculated before. So we will draw a perpendicular line to link AB. Whenever you are getting confused in which direction you will start to draw velocity diagram, then consider or then look over the rotation of crank. Whenever it is rotating in the clockwise direction, then start with the right side direction. So from point B, draw a BP line perpendicular to PB, that is the connecting rod. Now here we get the point P, that is the velocity vector of link BP. Now we have marked the point P and we will join the point A and P, because the slider P, we will find out the velocity. So velocity vector of the slider is parallel to the line of stroke. So because of that only we have joined line AP. Here we won't get the point D. So method to find the point which is in between the link is to divide the point or divide the link in the same ratio as the configuration diagram. Now here the point D is in between point P and B. Three points P, D, B all are on the same link. So we will divide in the ratio BP divided by BD is equal to linear velocity BP divided by BD. We put these values, we will get the linear velocity as BD is equal to 0.5 divided by 2 into 0.37, that is 0.925 centimeter. So now we will mark point D, which is apart from point B, 0.925. Now we will join point D and point A. This line represents the velocity at point D, that is VD. So now we will calculate the velocities of various links. So velocity of vector AP is, we have to measure the length of the link AP. This is the linear velocity. Now velocity of PB is to need to measure the length of the link PB. Now velocity of D is to, you need to measure the vector AD. Now here we get the three different values. Now we have to find out the angular velocity of link PB. So linear velocity is equal to R into omega. R is the length of the link PB into omega PB. So linear velocity is 22.2 is equal to length of the link PB is 2 into omega PB. So from that we will get the angular velocity omega PB is equal to 11.1 radian per second. Now we have to draw acceleration diagram. Before that we need to start with the configuration diagram. First of all, draw a configuration diagram, then draw velocity diagram, then calculate velocities of the different links, and then we will start with to find out the various accelerations of links. So in the table we will put the links AB, BP and slider P. Lengths of the link 0.5 and 2. Third one is the slider, so it won't have any length. So velocities we have measured from the velocity diagram for the link AB is 31.415, for the link BP 22.2, for the slider 26.4. Now we know the normal component of acceleration is v square upon r. For link AB it is 1973.804, BP 246.42, and for slider it is a straight line in motion. Now for tangential component, as AB is crank rotating with uniform speed, tangential component of acceleration of the link AB is 0. Now for BP, we won't know the value of tangential component of acceleration, but we know it is perpendicular to the link BP or to the normal component of acceleration of link BP. The third part, for the slider, direction is parallel to the line of stroke. So now here we will start with the fixed points. First of all, we will find out the fixed point as A, from where we will draw a vector AB parallel to the line of AB. We will take a suitable scale and we will find this line. We know that velocity is uniform, so tangential component is 0 for the crank AB. Therefore, the total acceleration is only the normal component of link AB. We will assume a suitable scale and we will draw acceleration diagram. So now from point B, we will start to move point P. So first of all, we will draw a normal component that is parallel to the line BP, that is BP dash, and the name of the component is normal component BP. From that point, we will start to find out the tangential component. The tangential component is always perpendicular to the normal component. So here we get an infinite line of P dash P. Now from slider, we will draw a line parallel or parallel to the line of stroke, that is AP. Now we will join or intersect the lines AP and tangential component of line P dash P. The intersection point is P. Now we will locate this point P. Now we will join line P to B. That is the total acceleration or the summation of the accelerations of normal and tangential components. Now we don't know where is the point D. So for finding the point D, we will divide the same line in the same ratio as per the configuration diagram. So here BP divided by BD is equal to the acceleration component. The point D must be on the line BDP or PDB. So we will divide the line BP divided by BD. So we will put the values and we will get the length 1.425 centimeter in the acceleration diagram. So from point B, we will mark the point D. Now we will join the point D with A, and the line is total acceleration of link AD. Now our acceleration diagram is done. We will find out the angular acceleration of link BP. For that, we will measure the tangential component acceleration of link BP, that is 1375. Length of the link BP is 2 and angular acceleration is alpha BP. So from that we will get alpha BP as 687.5 radian per second square in clockwise direction.